They say that March comes in like a lion and goes out like a lamb. And sure enough, the wind was roaring outside. I had a lot on my mind, you know, so I poured myself a tall glass of milk when suddenly there was a knock at my door. Or more like a beep on my screen.
Hello? Can you hear me?
Well, hey, just the marmot I wanted to see. I need your help, MC. I'm on the trail of something. Something big. I got 65 suspects. I gotta narrow it down to just one by the end of March.
Wow, that is big.
It is big, and that's where you come in. See, the problem with me is I get noticed because I'm a handsome man. And I also have to stay 6 feet away from everybody. But see, that's where you come in. You know, you and your roving rodent team, you can go anywhere. You gotta be my eyes, and my ears, and my nose, and my tail, and everything else for me. You think you can do that?
What's in it for us?
Exposure, duh. Let me rephrase that. How about the satisfaction of a job well done? We might throw in some snacks.
All right, we'll take the case. Our first matchup of 2021, set rodent against rodent. Folks, it has been a rough year for all of us on this planet. These things happen. The Hopi chipmunk was transported to Rocky Mountain National Park in Colorado, where it began to forage. Suddenly, it was ambushed by the very territorial wolf, which began smacking it upside the head. The bewildered chipmunk bolted, leaving the victorious wolf as the wild card winner. And so, one suspect has been eliminated, but there are 64 left. Looking at the bracket told me that this case would take us all around the earth, and even under the sea. It was very mysterious. Why were there so many mythological references? Why were so many red animals mixed up in this? And just what is a platyzilla? Follow us as we investigate the mystery of March Mammal Madness. The game is a foot, or a wing, or a fin, as the case may be. Thank you for watching.